Hans Christian Andersen wrote a famous children's story titled The Emperor's New Clothes. It's about a king who's obsessed with wearing fancy attire. Some con men realize they can get rich by promising to make the king an outfit using the most amazing material. The material is said to be unimaginably beautiful to everyone, except to stupid people who can't see it at all. The con men pretend to weave the fabric, even though they're only weaving a lie. They understand that people don't want to be called stupid and that people will pretend to see the fabric even when there's nothing there, simply to avoid being called stupid. So the king's officials and the king himself praise the non-existent new garb. "It's so beautiful! It's marvelous! I've never seen anything like it!" The con men eventually make off like bandits as the king parades himself through the town, stark raving naked. These con men in Andersen's story apparently took a page from Muhammad's playbook, although they seem like mere amateurs when compared with the Prophet of Islam. Nearly 14 centuries ago, Muhammad spent 23 years delivering bits and pieces of what eventually would become this book, the Quran. Many of his contemporaries mocked his verses, and I don't see how any honest critic can regard the Quran as anything other than a disaster. The British philosopher of religion, Anthony Flew, said that to read the Quran is a penance rather than a pleasure. Let's read two verses of the Quran, chapter 33, verse 36. "It is not for a believer, man or woman, when Allah and His Messenger have decreed a matter, that they should have any option in their decision. And whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger, he has indeed strayed into a plain error." Notice, once a decision has been made by Allah and Muhammad, a true believer's only option is obedience, which means that if you don't obey, or if you even think you've got other options, you're not a true believer. Chapter 4, verse 65. "But know, by your Lord, they can have no faith until they make you, O Muhammad, judge in all disputes between them and find in themselves no resistance against your decisions and accept them with full submission." Muslims can have no real faith until they find in themselves no resistance against Muhammad's decisions. If you have any resistance at all to what Muhammad says, you're not a real Muslim. Why is this important? Well, if you've recited the Shahada, but you turn out not to be a Muslim because you don't obey Allah or because you doubt Muhammad's commands, the penalty for apostasy is death. Sunan an-Nasa'i, 4069. The Messenger of Allah said, whoever changes his religion, kill him. So if you show the slightest doubt about anything said by Allah or Muhammad, you run the risk of having your head chopped off. Not surprisingly, the tendency among Muslims for the past 14 centuries has been to praise all things Islamic with ever-increasing zeal, regardless of that irritating burden we call reality. Let's look at a few examples. In his book 23 Years, Iranian scholar Ali Dashti writes, "The Quran contains sentences which are incomplete and not fully intelligible without the aid of commentaries, foreign words, unfamiliar Arabic words, and words used with other than the normal meaning. Adjectives and verbs inflected without observance of the concords of gender and number, illogically and ungrammatically applied pronouns which sometimes have no referent, and predicates which in rhymed passages are often remote from the subjects. These and other such aberrations in the language have given scope to critics who deny the Quran's eloquence." What about science? The Quran claims that the sun sets in a muddy pool. That semen is formed between the backbone and ribs.
That the earth is flat. That there are seven Earths.
Not trying to be indie, not trying to be cool, just trying to be in this room. Robbie, you know too, I can feel where the wind is, I can feel it through all of the windows inside this room. Yeah, yeah. But I cannot touch you, Robbie, I wanna feel you too. I wanna see the sunrise and my sins just forgive me. Light it up, oh my Lord, I'll be up tonight. Wanna make it up.
That the sun orbits the earth.
Never let me be alone. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right. I'll hold you when things go wrong. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right.
Human embryos go through a blood clot stage.
My face is down on the carpet. I found a way to fit. I can feel where the wind is. I can feel it through all of the windows inside this room. But I cannot touch you, Robbie, and I wanna feel you too. I wanna see the sunshine and my sins just forgiven. Light it up, oh my Lord, I'll be up tonight. Wanna make it up for all my wrongs I try. Never let me be alone. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right. I'll hold you when things go wrong. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right. Stay with me from dusk till dawn. Robbie, you're right.
The sky would fall on the earth if Allah didn't hold it up. And that stars are missiles that Allah uses to shoot demons who try to sneak into heaven. Thank you. How do Muslims respond when they read this scientific catastrophe? The Quran is a scientific miracle filled with biological and astronomical insights that couldn't be proven until centuries after they were revealed. This is conclusive proof that the Quran comes from God. What about ethics? The Quran commands Muslims to violently subjugate Jews and Christians.
Before I go, let me put my last weight on you. This life is worthless if you don't put Allah first. Love each other, keep your faith. Don't let shaitan be your friend. Swallow the cure to unlock your paradise, yeah. If you see my burden shaking, never cry tomorrow. You should remember, every soul shall taste the day. No, I will last forever. This is not a destiny. Oh, oh, oh. But if my time is up, is my soul Allah, as I'm flying away.
Last breath, I guess my name.